guys, my name's Gavin and welcome back to a new video. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make virtual beats for one last time inside of FL Studio. In this video I'm going to kind of intertwine all of the stuff that I've talked about in the previous videos and wrap it up all into like one kind of tutorial for you guys to enjoy. So yeah, follow me on Instagram if you haven't already at GavinHeadley_. Join my Discord, there's going to be a link down in the description, so you can just click it. And yeah, come talk to me in there. And without further ado, let's get in the video. All right, so Flex is an awesome plugin that actually came with my FL Studio. I have the producer edition, so the $200 version. And I just kind of like figured out that it was there the other day. I didn't even know it was there. But I used the synth block Plectrum, and I laid down this pattern. So it's really simple. This is an E minor chord. And I rose that up and I arpeggiated all of the chords. So I put the third up an octave to the fifth. Arpeggiated all of the chords, and it's the same process this whole time. So if we bring this down, C major, D, D major, you know, A minor, and then B major. So yeah, that's my progression. I wanted to do something almost happy feeling, except I guess, okay, so this isn't really like, it's in the minor scale. It's in, right now we're in E minor, but when you listen to the melody, I previewed it at the beginning of the video, it doesn't sound sad whatsoever. And I guess I'm going to talk about how I kind of did that. Because normally the minor scale, especially like the Aeolian scale that I'm in right now, is like a sadder scale. So how I did that, there's a bunch of different things at the same time. Alright, so now in a lot of virtual beats, they have like this kind of like EDM series of like note plucks, like right here. And basically it's just going down the scale and kind of just picking out notes that I think fit well, and then just doing that three note pluck to them. So we don't have to worry about this part right here. So yeah, it's just going up and down the scale. This is a perfect example of the wave. I talk about it in every single one of my videos. Perfect example of it right here. It literally just looks like a wave just going up and down the scale. And then for this, the top kind of melody to, I guess it's something kind of, it's a top melody to counter this bottom melody. So like this is, there's no music theory to this whatsoever. This is really just me using my ear, which I would consider kind of developed. I've been making beats for a little bit. And so if you're new to producing, and aren't really satisfied with that answer, that's just how it really is. No amount of music theory is gonna make you have better melodies. It's all about developing your ear. And like when I make this melody, I don't make it with music theory in mind, because that's not a good way of doing it, in my opinion. You kind of lose the creative aspect of the whole music making process, which is like the most important part of it, obviously. So it's just like using your ear. After I had this, I just did Alt R on my keyboard to randomize it. I put it in the mixer. I didn't add any effects to it. I thought it sounded good how it was. So then I laid down this counter melody. Alright, so here, I really like this melody, but I thought it was getting a little too repetitive. So I originally, it was just this first two bars right here. If I highlight it, you know what I mean? These two bars, it was just looping the whole time. But I actually just decided to use this note, because as we were going down and up and down the scale, this note is a really pleasing one to my ear. It was a pleasing one to my ear, and I just thought, like, I just wanted to continue that wave shape right here a little bit, going back down and up the scale. And like these notes were originally down to like this, but if I rose them up, and like I forget what this is called in the Aeolian scale, but there's a series of two notes that are right next to each other that really do a good job making the beat sound more melodic. And it's like a really easy thing to do to make your melodies sound a little bit cooler than they already do, just using those two notes. Like, they're really just pleasing to the ear. And then after that, I just did Alt R, and then I added no effects again. I just left it how it was, and that was another Flex preset. It was the Arcson Cityscape Tesla Pipe sound. So yeah, after that I'll move on to the next sound. Just the same chord progression from the original melody that we laid down in Flex. It's a piano from Omnisphere, and then I added a bunch of different effects to it. So that's what it sounds like. That's what it sounds like without effects. It's like a normal kind of piano melody. So I started by putting this phaser on it. It's like a really subtle effect. You can't really notice it. And a little bit of reverb. Microshift. And the thing that really gives it its virtual feel is this Transgate 1 from Grossbeat. And after that, my favorite part of the melody is this kind of bass line. It's not really a bass line. It is if you were to put it down an octave, but I put it up an octave, so it acts kind of more of a melody. But this is where stuff gets interesting. This is what makes it like not sound as sad. So it's just getting a groove. We're following the bass line for the most part, except I'll talk about these. This is just the bass line. It's like this note. These notes, I don't think the B was in the scale, but the A was. But these are called passing tones. And if you develop your ear to a certain degree, like, I don't know how to explain this music theory-wise, but if you develop your ear to a certain degree, you'll be able to start picking out these passing tones in your melodies and incorporating them and using them a lot more. And I just recently discovered this kind of thing. I gotta stop saying kind of. Why do I say that? Yeah. So these are called passing tones, and this is another one right here. Like, this note really makes it sound a lot more happier. A lot more happy. And then this is the leading tone in the scale, which is in the Aeolian scale, the note below the root note of their scale. So our root note that we were working on is E. And yeah, so after I laid that down, didn't add anything onto it, I thought it was fine how it was. And that almost concludes the melody, but now I want to talk a little bit about vocals and how you can add your own vocals to your melodies, and I just gotta find my original one that I did right here. That's the vocal that I added on. I'm gonna play what it sounds like before I actually I can't I don't have the stems, but what I did, if I can find it, I added reverb just to make it sound a little bit more like a pad. EQ, I took out some of the high end just to make it sound more underwater, and sometimes I mess with the low end too to make it sound a little bit more just like empty, but I didn't do it for this one. And then I added Altar Boy, and I sung it in a really high pitch. So normally I would use this pitch shifter and move it up an octave, but I actually moved it down an octave, and then I blended it back a little bit to like mix in a little bit more low end with my voice. And yeah, that's something that Nick Mira does a lot in his beats, where he uses his own vocals, and I think it's something that definitely needs to happen a lot more in people's vocals or in people's beats, because it's just, I don't know, it's really cool, really unique. And like, your voice is the most powerful instrument and easiest to use for most people, because like, you can literally do whatever you want on it without having to use your fingers, which is kind of hard. That's a part that makes instruments hard if you don't have a good ear. So yeah, that's basically a really cool thing to do in your melodies. And yeah, so after that, I just structured it out like a loop. Disregard this guy, that's the finish loop. I just structured out all of them playing, and then one at a time after that. And then I got this, I pitched it down one semitone, and then I routed it to my master channel, where I didn't do anything on it because I thought it sounded fine. And that's definitely something that is okay to do. Like, you don't have to add a bunch of effects on everything. Like, I really didn't add that much effects on this, like no cassettes. I feel like in virtual, you don't need that cassette kind of thing. It also, you can use it at the same time. Why am I looking at my phone? You can do it at the same time, but that just proves that there's like no real rules in music, I guess. So yeah, that's basically the video. I hope that you were able to learn something, pick something out of this, use the tutorials to go ahead and make your melody sound a little bit more unique and virtual, I guess you can say. And yeah, that's about it for the video. Hope you guys enjoyed. Again, join my Discord, please. I want to get a bunch of guys in there, and I want to have a good time with it. And yeah, that's about it for the video. I hope you have an awesome rest of your day. It's Easter today, so celebrate that in whatever way that you can with the whole quarantine thing. But yeah, continue to make beats, and have an awesome rest of your day.